Did you know your body has a self-repair mechanism so powerful it can literally recycle damaged cells, boost your immune system, and transform your metabolism, all in just 36 hours? I know, it sounds too good to be true. But stay with me, because what I'm about to reveal about the 36-hour fast will completely change the way you see health. And no, you won't starve to death. Listen, for years we've been told to eat every 3 to 4 hours to keep our metabolism running. Breakfast, snack, lunch, snack, dinner, an endless cycle. But here's the problem. Your body never gets the time to clean up. Imagine your house. If you're constantly cooking and eating but never cleaning, what happens? The mess piles up, waste accumulates, the environment becomes toxic. Well, that's exactly what happens inside your body when you're constantly eating. The 36-hour fast isn't a punishment. It's not a restrictive diet. It's giving your body the time it desperately needs to regenerate, detox, and repair itself on a cellular level. But before you dive in headfirst, there are some crucial things you absolutely must know. And trust me, I learned the hard way. If that sounds interesting, drop a like, give it a boost, hit subscribe, and let's go. Before we start, let's talk about the science behind the 36-hour fast, the perfect metabolic timing. When you stop eating, your body goes through several fascinating metabolic phases. The first 12 hours, your body burns through its glycogen reserves. That's the stored glucose in your liver and muscles. Nothing revolutionary here. It happens every night while you sleep. But after that, that's when the magic begins. Between 12 and 16 hours, your body transitions into ketosis. Your insulin levels drop dramatically by about 20 to 30%. That's great news because chronically high insulin is linked to type 2 diabetes, inflammation, and accelerated aging. After about 18 hours, or sooner for some, an incredible process called autophagy kicks into high gear. The word comes from Greek, auto, self, and phagy, to eat. Literally, your cells start eating themselves. Wait, don't leave. It's actually amazing. Autophagy is your body's recycling system. Your cells identify damaged proteins, malfunctioning organelles, and cellular debris, and break them down to reuse the useful parts. It's like turning old rusty cars into spare parts to build new ones. In 2025, Dr. Andrea Balabio won the Beth Levine Prize for revealing how lysosomes control cell metabolism and trigger autophagy. Between 24 and 36 hours, autophagy peaks. Your body enters deep repair mode. Stem cells regenerate. Your immune system renews itself. Your brain produces more BDNF, brain-derived neurotrophic factor, which promotes the growth of new neurons. Your mitochondria, the power plants of your cells, become more efficient. You literally create new mitochondria, a process called mitochondrial biogenesis. And here's the cherry on top. Your growth hormone can increase by 300 to 500%, according to some studies. That's the hormone responsible for muscle repair, fat burning, and cellular rejuvenation. But there's a catch, a big one. You only get these benefits if you follow some non-negotiable rules. Ignore them, and you might end up with dizziness, cramps, or a metabolic crash. So, how do you do it right? All of this science is powerful, but your preparation for fasting determines the outcome. Miss this setup, and you miss the transformation. How to prepare for your 36-hour fast? Rule number one, timing is everything. Never start your fast on a Monday morning before a stressful work week. That's the perfect recipe for failure. The best time? Start after dinner on Sunday night. You'll fast all day Monday while staying busy, sleep Monday night, and break your fast Tuesday morning. Simple and effective. Why does it work? Because you sleep through a big part of it, and during the day your mind stays busy, so hunger fades naturally. Food preparation, the three-day rule. Don't make the rookie mistake, "I'll eat everything I can before fasting." No, just no. Here's what to do instead. 72 hours before, gradually cut refined carbs, bye-bye white bread, pasta, and sweets. Focus on quality protein, healthy fats, avocado, nuts, olive oil, and fibrous veggies. 48 hours before, boost your electrolytes, quality salt, sea salt, or Himalayan, potassium, green veggies, avocado, and magnesium, nuts, seeds. 24 hours before, your last meal should be high in healthy fats, moderate in protein. Think salmon with greens and olive oil, or steak with salad and avocado. Avoid simple carbs. They'll spike your blood sugar and crash it a few hours later, making you miserable. Smart hydration. Remember this forever. Hydration does not equal just water. During your fast, you'll lose electrolytes, especially sodium. Drinking plain water alone can actually dilute them and make you feel sick. Your hydration plan. 2 to 3 liters of water per day, minimum. Add a pinch of sea salt to each glass. Yes, really. Bone broth or salted veggie broth. Technically not a pure water fast, but with only 10 to 15 calories, it won't break autophagy and can save you from cramps. Black coffee or green tea. Both are allowed and even help reduce hunger. But careful. Too much caffeine on an empty stomach can cause palpitations. Stick to 2 to 3 cups max. Your hour-by-hour journey, hours 0 to 8, the comfort zone. You'll feel almost nothing. It's like any other night after dinner. By morning, you might feel a bit hungry, but that's habit, not real need. Tip: drink a glass of salted water when you wake up. Stay busy. Go for a walk, work, keep your mind occupied. Hunger comes in waves. Ignore it for 15 to 20 minutes, and it fades. Hours 8 to 16, the transition. Welcome to the adjustment zone. Your body realizes, hey, no food's coming, and starts switching to fat-burning mode. This can feel uncomfortable, possible symptoms. Irritability, hangry mode. Feeling cold, slight energy dip, stomach rumbling. But here's the secret. These symptoms are temporary. They last 2 to 4 hours, then your body adapts. Tip, have some salted broth, drink green tea, stay busy. Hours 16 to 24, the turning point. Something magical happens here. Your hunger almost disappears. Your brain switches to ketones, premium brain fuel made from fat. You might feel mentally sharper and even more energetic. Autophagy is now in full swing. Your cells are doing a deep clean. Tip, use this mental clarity for creative or focused work. Hours 24 to 36, deep transformation. You're now in maximum repair mode. Your immune system regenerates. Stem cells multiply. Inflammation drops. DNA damage repairs. You might feel light, clear-headed, maybe even euphoric. That's not your imagination. Your brain releases endorphins and runs efficiently on ketones. Tip, stay gentle. Light walks only. Avoid heavy workouts. Let your body do its inner work, breaking your fast safely. The fatal mistake to avoid. Here's the mistake so many people make. After 36 hours of fasting, they dive into a huge meal. Pizza, burger, dessert. I deserve it. No, listen to me closely. Your digestive system has been at rest for 36 hours. Your digestive enzymes are at a minimum. Your stomach has contracted. If you bombard it with a feast, you're going to regret it bitterly. And I know what I'm talking about. During one of my first times after 39 hours of fasting, I made a huge mistake when breaking it. I started with an avocado. So far, so good. But then, 2.5 eggs, beans, garlic, chili, onions, bread. And to top it all off, I downed nearly 300 grams of yogurt. Big, big mistake. A few minutes later, my eyelids became heavy as lead, dizziness. I collapsed on the couch, unable to move, phone in hand. That post-meal fatigue lasted until 4 p.m., almost 7 hours of drowsiness and heaviness. My body, used to running on ketones, suddenly had to handle an avalanche of food. Blood rushed to my digestive system. My pancreas dumped a massive amount of insulin. The whole system rebooted brutally. That was the price to pay for breaking the fast like a brute. Symptoms of a catastrophic fast break: intense stomach cramps, explosive diarrhea. Yes, sorry, but that's the reality. Nausea, extreme bloating, sudden and overwhelming lethargy, like in my case, dizziness and mental confusion. In extreme cases, it's called refeeding syndrome, and it's potentially dangerous. So since that day, I've learned, and I'm going to give you the exact protocol to avoid ending up like me on that couch. The perfect breaking protocol. First step, first 10 to 15 minutes. Start with a small glass of water with lemon. It gently wakes up your digestive system. After 15 minutes, eat something small, easily digestible, and nutrient-rich. My suggestions: half an avocado with a pinch of salt. Not a whole avocado like I did. Learn from my lesson. A handful of almonds or nuts, a soft boiled egg, a small bowl of bone broth with cooked vegetables. Chew slowly, savor every bite. Your body will absorb these nutrients like a sponge. After 30 to 60 minutes, if you feel good, eat a light but complete meal. Think easily digestible proteins: fish, eggs, chicken, healthy fats, olive oil, avocado, cooked vegetables, easier to digest than raw. Avoid heavy carbs for now. Absolutely avoid in the first 2 to 3 hours. Refined sugars, fried foods, large amounts of dairy, especially not 300 grams of yogurt at once, trust me. Large amounts of raw fiber or legumes. Two complex mixes, garlic plus chili plus onions plus everything else equals bad idea. Alcohol. Your next meal, 3 to 4 hours later, can be normal, but stay tuned to your body. But wait, before you dive headfirst into your first 36-hour fast, there are critical things you need to know. Because for some people, this fast can turn into a medical nightmare. And I'm serious here. We're not just talking discomfort, we're talking real danger. When you should not do a 36-hour fast. 36 hours is powerful, but it's not for everyone. Never fast if you're pregnant or breastfeeding, you have an eating disorder, you have type 1 diabetes, you're under 18, you're underweight, BMI less than 18.5, consult your doctor fasting. If you have type 2 diabetes, you take blood pressure meds, you have heart, kidney, or thyroid issues, and if during your fast you experience severe dizziness, heart palpitations, confusion, chest pain, blurred vision, stop immediately. Building up to 36 hours. Don't jump straight into it. Smart progression. Weeks 1 to 2. 16, 8 intermittent fasting. Weeks 3 to 4, 18/6. Weeks 5 to 6, 24-hour fast. Week 7, plus, you're ready for 36 hours. This trains your metabolism and mindset. The benefits beyond the fast. The 36-hour fast isn't a magic cure, it's a tool. You can use it once a month for a deep reset, once a week for regular detox, a few times a year for anti-aging benefits. Science shows brain, more neuroplasticity, better memory, protection from Alzheimer's and Parkinson's. Metabolism, improved insulin sensitivity, fat metabolism, and muscle preservation. Longevity, in animal studies, lifespan increased 30 to 40%. Inflammation, lower CRP and IL-6 levels, better autoimmune balance. Immunity, regenerated immune cells, better defense against infections and cancer cells. Evolutionary perspective. Fasting isn't a trend, it's how humans evolved. For millions of years, our ancestors alternated between feasting and fasting. Your body is designed to work this way. Autophagy, ketosis, regeneration, these aren't malfunctions, they're built-in features. Eating constantly, keeping insulin high 24/7. That's what's unnatural. A 36-hour fast is simply returning to your biological rhythm. So, are you ready to hit the reset button? Conclusion. You now have everything you need to complete a 36-hour fast safely. Quick recap. Prepare properly. Reduce carbs, boost electrolytes, choose the right timing. Smart hydration, salted water, broth, coffee, not plain water, only. Be patient. First 16 hours are an adjustment. Break the fast slowly and gently. Listen to your body. Discomfort is normal, pain is not. But here's my real question. What's stopping you from trying? Fear of hunger? You now have the tools to manage it. Fear of losing muscle? Science says your growth hormone protects it. Lack of motivation? Remember the benefits. Clearer brain, stronger immunity, repaired cells. Start gradually. Don't jump in if you've never fasted before, but if you already do intermittent fasting, 36 hours is your next evolution. And if you've done it before, tell me in the comments. What was your experience? What surprised you? What tips would you share? If you found this video helpful, share it with someone who could benefit. Fasting is one of the most powerful yet misunderstood health tools out there. Subscribe for more science-based content to help you optimize your health naturally. We break myths. We uncover what really works. Note, this is not medical advice, it's educational content based on scientific studies. Always consult your doctor before any prolonged fast. See you in the next video. Take care of yourself.